Hi everyone, J7409 here with you with some weather news update. The name you know, the news that you can use, and it's looking like that storm that I talked about over a week ago when I said it's the possibility of a Halloween storm. Well, it's going to turn into a East Coast storm, my friends, developing Friday into the weekend, and it could be very powerful. What you're looking at here is the surface pressure, and this, of course, is from the European model. I want you to take note of that, as you can see right up here. Now, it's a significant fall storm. It may form along the East Coast late this week as a cold front combines with the remnants of Category 5 Hurricane Willa. Yes, Willa is a Category 5 now, with I'll show you in a moment. Catastrophic winds with higher gusts. I'll put it at that. Now, the storm may generate heavy rain, mountain snow, and at the coast, strong winds and high seas. You need to be aware of this. You know, I had one person comment, right? Yeah, Willa is going to make this storm. Ha ha. Well, it is, like I've been showing you guys all along. Now, the biggest risk of destructive weather will be in the mid-Atlantic and northeast over the weekend. It's really too soon to project exactly how this storm will unfold and where it will hit the hardest. There's also a chance it's steered more out to sea. Now, if that happens, it's going to minimize the effects and they will not be anywhere as bad as it looks like it possibly could be. Now, the storm threat is still 5 to 6 days away, but computer models show the pattern favorable for the East Coast storms in late October for more than a week, just like I showed you guys. Now, like all the East Coast storms, the exact track will determine where the heaviest precipitation occurs and what locations, if any, might see snow. Now, there's also uncertainty in the storm strength, which will have big implications for how much precipitation actually falls. You guys know that, and what type and whether strong winds and flooding becomes a threat along the coast. But I hate to tell you this, most models are suggesting this storm has the potential to be formidable. It will develop as the remnants of Willa. Just like I've been trying to get in your heads, the remnants of this powerful hurricane Willa presently is situated in the eastern tropical Pacific Ocean near Mexico's west coast. Well, they're going to be drawn northeast from Mexico into the Gulf of Mexico by midweek. A new storm system will form along an old stalled out front and track from the northern Gulf Coast through the southeast on Thursday and Friday. Now, Willow should make landfall tomorrow sometime in Mexico. Now, Willow's remnants as they enter the Gulf of Mexico will not bear any similarity to the monster storm in its current state as it is right now. It will be much weaker. Now, over the Gulf of Mexico, it is not out of the question that the remnant circulation attempts to regenerate into a tropical entity, but models do not presently predict this. Now, this, of course, is precipitation. As you can see, where it's red, that's like, could be like 3.5 to 4 inches or better. As the colors come down, right on through green is the less, the blue is a little more. That's the way it's going. Now, so far as Willa's remnants at first, they're likely to produce substantial rainfall over central Texas. I hate to tell you guys this, which has recently, been going through all this severe flooding. And this rain should happen on Wednesday. Now, the rain is then likely to spread on Thursday and Friday over some of the areas hit by Hurricane Michael. This just bothers me terribly, including the Florida Panhandle and the state of Georgia. Now, as the storm system develops and tracks along the northern Gulf Coast toward the mid-Atlantic and northeast, models project rainfall totals of about 1 to 4 inches. Now, this may be enough to cause Pockets of flooding, especially in the areas that have had substantial rain in the recent weeks, but widespread issues are less likely. Now, the storm system will be moving along fast enough to prevent a more serious flood threat than that, but that's enough for everybody who's been having all of these floodings and Hurricane Michael, and it's not going to take much before trees topple, more flash flooding happens, and who knows, you might even lose some power. Now, here's Friday night and Saturday night. It's two different possible storm center locations, and this is using the European map modeling system. Okay, now the storm system itself is not expected to gain significant strength until it reaches the East Coast on Friday or Friday night. That's when it will begin to interact with the cold front. Now, the timing and location of this merger will have significant implications for the storm track and how big a deal the storm becomes along the East Coast. Now, if the merger occurs earlier and closer to the coast, the storm is more likely to come right up the coast with significant rain, snow, and wind. But if it occurs later and farther offshore, it may mean more of a glancing blow. Now, this is what it's looking like of the Europeans modeling system's 51 simulators. These are the two best. Okay, about half keep the storm close to the mid-Atlantic and northeast coast, and the other half take it more out to sea. So we're just going to have to wait and see what happens. I've been talking for days and days on end, telling you we were going to have to see where this genesis happened, where this system met the cold front. That's exactly what is going to happen. We have to wait and see. Now, if it takes and meets on Friday night in this area, it's going to go up. It's going to cause all kind of havoc along the coastline moving on up, and that's when the snow can happen in New England. So, with that all said and done, please subscribe, my friends. I would appreciate it so much. And please be aware of this storm going on. Please do that. And it is coming from the remnants of Willa that will make up again. And right quickly, we will go over what's happening in the Pacific. There's nothing going on in the Atlantic. We do have disturbance number one here. It's just showers and thunderstorms, and they've decreased today in association with that small area of low pressure. It's located, though, about 800 miles south-southwest of the southern tip of Baja California Peninsula. Environmental conditions are expected to be marginally conducive for some gradual development of this system during the next couple of days. So in 2 days, you got a 20% chance, 5 days, a 20% chance, because if it does pick up any steam, it's going to run into some environmental conditions such as shear wind that is going to mess it up. And disturbance number one isn't going to do too much as of now. Now we have Tropical Storm Vincent. It has 45 mile per hour winds. Its minimum central pressure, 1,004 millibars. If you're tracking, located at 14.9 north, 100.8 west, moving west northwest at 12 miles per hour. And then, what's the latest on the monster Willa? She is a Category 5. Her winds are 160 miles per hour with higher gust. The pressure, 925 millibars. I looked this up on a different chart a little earlier today. It was like 27 point something. I can't remember right off the hand here, but I remember when I saw 27, I was freaking out. That is some low barometric pressure. Now, it's located 19.4 north, 107.2 west. It's moving north at 7 miles per hour. The only good thing about Willa, everybody please in Mexico, get right. Please get right. It should, once it hits land and it loses its steam right in this area, you guys right in this area, please prepare. Okay? Anywhere up and down this coast here, prepare for Willa. It should go ahead and start to disintegrate and come right on down, just bringing much rain to Texas. So that's an update on what's going on. I hope everyone is ready. Let's all hope and pray that the storm stays further out to sea. If not, it could cause problems for many, many, many people on the East Coast. Thank you so much for watching. I love you. Your comments, please upvote and share this information. Everybody have a good evening. Peace, love, and kindness to all. Thank you for watching.